हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक ऑन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ट्रांजैक्शन। इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फ्लैट एंड नेस्टेड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ट्रांजैक्शन एंड नेस्टेड बैंकिंग ट्रांजैक्शन एंड आल्सो हाउ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बैंकिंग ट्रांजैक्शन शुड बी अप्लाई इन अ नेस्टेड बैंकिंग ट्रांजैक्शन एंड आल्सो वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एटॉमिक कमिट प्रोटोकॉल। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ एटॉमिक कमिट प्रोटोकॉल आल्सो वी डिस्कस्ड, वन फेज एटॉमिक कमिट प्रोटोकॉल एंड टू फेज कमिट प्रोटोकॉल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए न्यू टॉपिक कॉल्ड एज ए लॉकिंग। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लॉकिंग, लेट्स डिस्कस ए ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट कंकरेंसी कंट्रोल। कंकरेंसी कंट्रोल इन ए डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम, इन अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ट्रांजेक्शन। सो कंकरेंसी कंट्रोल मीन्स इट शुड बी पैरेलली एक्सेस टू द लॉकिंग फंक्शन। दिस इज द मेन कॉन्सेप्ट बिहाइंड द कंकरेंसी कंट्रोल। इन कंकरेंसी कंट्रोल, ईच सर्वर manages a set of object and is responsible for ensuring that they remain consistent, for which accurate and we should be a current transaction and it should be a parallelly run through a locking. And finally, it is responsible for applying the concurrency control to its own object. This is one object, this is another object. We have to concurrency control. This is parallelly attracts each other in this function, locking function. Now, this implies if transaction T, this is transaction T, if implies the transaction T is before transfer the transaction U in their conflicting. U means concurrency control, uses the concurrency control. U in the conflicting access, the object one of the server, either this server or this server. We have to conflict that server. Then they must be order at all the server, whole object are accessed in the conflicts managed by both T and U. T is the transaction and U is the concurrency control of an object. That is concurrency control. This is timestamping and this is concurrency control. Now, we'll move on to locking. In a distributed transaction, the locks an object or held locally. That is, we have to held locally. It means it should be acts in a single server. It should be in a same server. And also it should be in a same server. The loads of the locking should be a object. And it should be a decide whether to grant a lock or make the requesting transaction should be wait. We have to transfer this transaction to the another U and it should be wait till the B happens in a transaction T. This is the main locking. If you transfer this one, we have to lock this one and we have to move on to a wait function. After wait, we have to release this transaction. This is the concept. Next, a lock manages in different servers and set their locks depending or independent of one another. It is possible that difficult server may impose the different ordering on transaction and it should be considered the interleaving of transaction, that is T and U, that is T and U at server. Which type of server? One is X server and another one is Y server. Now, by using this concept, we have to discuss about timestamping and concurrency control. Timestamp and concurrency control. We have to discuss about timestamping and using concurrency control. In a single server transaction, the conditions increases a unique timestamp to each transaction when it stacks requires the equivalence in enforce the communicating. We have to use all those things for timestamping and run in a single server, and time should be a move to the one transaction to another transaction. It means, what do you call that? That is called as a timestamping. The server of distributed transaction are jointly responsible for ensuring that they are performed version of an object, and it should be a transaction U commits. The transaction U should be commits after the version accused and accessed by the T at one server. After this, we have to access this T after a one server. If T and U access the same object as one another at other server, they must commit. Then there is a same order. To achieve this, the same ordering at all the servers conditions must be agree. And the same ordering function should be given to the wait function, and it should be released easily, the locking concept. This is the concept behind the locking. And last concept we discuss about optimistic concurrency control. In optimistic concurrency control, we are using this function. If you, the transaction and you should be wait, the read A, the object read A at one server, that is X server, after X and moves on to the read B, and it is another one server, Y server. X and Y server should be simultaneously running because it should be a concurrency parallel programming. And we have to write the function of A and also write the function of B. Both the functions should be run simultaneously because it should be in a parallel concept. Next, after that, read A and read B and write A and write B. Read B should be transferred to the transaction function, and that Y, the server should be in a transaction, and X should be in a U, concurrency pod. So after that, you have to write this function. After read, you have to write, correct? And then here also, we have to write this concept. This is the concept behind the optimistic concurrency control. Let's discuss the definition of optimistic concurrency control. In this, each transaction is validated before it is allowed to commit transaction numbers or assigned at the start of validation and coordination the actions, and it should be serialized according to the order of the transaction, and should be a distributed transaction that access its own object. This violation takes place during the first phase of two-phase commit protocol. Where we heard this commit protocol, it should be an atomic commit protocol. There are two types, one-phase and two-phase. But here in optimistic, we have to use the two-phase commit protocol. Same, we have to consider this following interleaving of transaction T and U, which access the objects A and which access the object B. At the server, two types of server we are using respectively here. Which are the servers? One, X server and Y server. So by using this concept, we have to solve the distributed transaction method. So these are all the concepts we have regarding the module 5 chapter. For next session, we'll discuss about module 4 regarding the different types of algorithm. So these are all for the today's class. For next session, we'll discuss about the algorithm parts regarding the distributed methods, and that is a time and global stats topic. So this is optimistic concept is very, very important for the examination point of view. Okay, for more updates, please subscribe my channel. Thank you one and all for listening to this session.